Hey everyone, today we are going to check out episode 4 of Game of Thrones. Let's get to it! Bran? Is it a flashback? It's more not like flashback, but more like a dream, perhaps? Whoa. Three eyes.
I don't want to go.
Neither do I. But Rob's Lord of Winterfell, which means I do what he says and you do what I say.
Whoa. He's huge.
Former welcome, my lad.
Oh, Tyrion in Winterfell.
Watch is welcome at Winterfell.
Any man of the Night's Watch, but not I, eh, boy?
I'm not your boy, Lannister. I'm Lord of Winterfell while my father is away.
Do you like to ride, Bran?
Yes. Well, I mean, I did like to.
With the right horse and saddle, even a cripple can ride.
I'm not a cripple.
Then I'm not a dwarf. My father will rejoice to hear it.
Father will rejoice to hear.
With a yearling, teach her to respond to the reins and to the boy's voice.
Ooh.
On horseback, you'll be as tall as any of them.
It is a nice gift.
Why do you want to help him?
I have a tender spot in my heart for cripples, bastards, and broken things.
Your loyalty to your captors is touching.
Captors?
Tell me. How do you think Balin Greyjoy would feel if you could see his only surviving son has turned lackey?
Okay, more...
Despair.
More lore information. I like that. So, there was a rebellion and... this guy's family lost. And he became, like, Stark's servant, it seems. And maybe if there will be a chance, he won't be so loyal anymore. So, okay. I need to keep an eye on him. He seems like now he seems an important character. Okay.
Pivot as you deliver the stroke with all your weight behind it.
Okay, more training.
They'll need an eight fell to fit him in.
I like Samuel Tarly. Okay, go back a little bit. I like how they. I now became like friends, like buddies, because in previous episode they wanted to kill Jon because he was better than them, but now, okay, Jon is training them, they becoming friends. I like that. Okay, new character.
Samuel Tarly. Hornhill. I mean, I was of Hornhill. I've come to take the black.
This. Training armor is so funny.
I yield. Please, no more.
You sure you want to do this?
No.
No. No. No, they don't, but they have to.
Well fought. Piss off. My mother calls me Sam.
It's not gonna get any easier, you know. You're gonna have to defend yourself.
Why didn't you get up and fight?
Why not?
I'm a coward. My father always says so.
It seems Sam is... I think that it was his family who sent him here. Just to get rid of him. Like, it seems he's not a good warrior. And maybe his family, all in his family are good warriors. And he's like a disgrace. So they just got rid of him, it seems.
Ice Dothrag, city of the horse lords.
Best these savages can do.
These are my people now. You shouldn't call them savages.
I'll call them what I like, because they're my people. This is my army.
With this attitude, you... I don't think that you will be a good king.
If my brother was given an army of Dothraki, could you conquer the Seven Kingdoms?
The Dothraki have never crossed the narrow sea. King Robert is fool enough to meet them in open battle. But the men advising him are different. Now Ned Stark wants my head. He drove me from my land.
You sold slaves.
Aye.
What happened to the dragons? I was told that brave men killed them all.
Yeah, that's very interesting.
Brave men didn't kill dragons. The
brave men rode them. The breath of the greatest dragon forged the Iron Throne, which the usurper is keeping warm for me.
We have always wanted to see a dragon. There's nothing in the world that I would rather see.
Really? Why dragons?
A few flaps of their wings and they're somewhere else. Far away.
So you like to be free like them?
I've seen a man from Ashai with a dagger of real dragon glass. I've seen a man who could change his face the way that other men change their clothes.
Ooh.
Pirate who wore his weight in gold and his ship had sails of colored silk.
I think she just mentioned some important characters that will appear in the future. Because many people in the comments always tell me to pay attention just in every small detail in dialogues, because in the future they will be important. So, I see. She said very interesting things.
There was Giscar and Valrion.
Giscar, Valrion.
Vermithrax.
Zuvius. Okay, a lot of dragon names.
And Beleriand the Dread, whose fire forged the seven kingdoms into one. You think I bought you to make Khal Drogo happy?
So it was...
Pretty little idiot.
So she's like a spy for him. She spies on Daenerys, and it seems she tells everything. Tells him everything that happened. Ooh. I see.
All the lords of Westeros will gather here to see the little prince.
How deep.
Like,
in House of the Dragon, this Iron Throne looked much bigger. Like, there was a lot more swords around it. But now it's just a throne. Honestly, I like the throne in House of the Dragon. I like it more.
If you only had girls, I suppose the throne would pass to Prince Joffrey's little brother.
And everyone would hate me.
Or Joffrey will take the second wife. Oh.
Who built the Iron Throne?
Aegon the Conqueror.
And who built the Red Keep?
Maegor the Cruel. Grandfather and uncle were murdered here, weren't they?
They were killed on the orders of King Ares, yes.
The Mad King.
Commonly known as the Mad King.
Why were they killed?
You should speak to your father about these matters.
I'm also interested.
I need more men.
You'll get 50. Lord Baelish will see it paid for.
I will.
You found money for the champions.
I will.
You'll find money to keep the peace. The sooner this is over, the better.
The realm prospers from such events, my lord. They give the great a chance of glory, and the lowly a respite from their woes.
Is he ill or what? He's sweating so much. Why?
Now, there's nothing else, my lords.
This heat. On days like this, I envy...
No, it's just hot inside. Okay.
I've been hoping to talk to you about John Arryn.
His death was a great sadness to all of us. I took personal charge of his care, but I could not save him. Lord John often came to me for counsel.
Why? What did John want the night before he died?
Oh, he came inquiring after a book.
A book?
What book?
Lineages and history of the great houses of the Seven Kingdoms.
This is a huge book.
Of many high lords. And noble ladies.
Did John Arryn tell you what he wanted with it?
He did not, my lord. I did not presume to ask.
Did he say anything to you during his final hours?
There was one phrase he kept repeating.
Mm-hmm.
The seed is strong, I think it was.
The seed is strong. Okay, he took the book. Maybe Lord Arryn, maybe he left something in this book. Like some kind of note that will help Ned to find out the truth.
Okay, Arya's training.
Sirio says a water dancer can stand on one toe for hours.
It's a hard fall down these steps.
Out of a hold fast.
You will marry a high lord and rule this castle. And your sons shall be knights and princes and lords.
No.
No. No. She wants to be a warrior, not princess like Sansa.
Sir Alistair said I'm to be your new watch partner.
Come stand by the fire. It's warmer.
Oh, that's all right. I'm fine.
You're not. You're freezing.
I'm really curious. Like, can they see what's happening? What's happening down at the base of the wall? This wall is really huge. I don't think without some kind of maybe magic or binoculars to see what's down. How they even keep in the watch, I'm really interested. Because if it's maybe just a few people, you can't see them at night. It's really dark. You only can see that enemy is coming if really huge army comes to the wall. So, maybe they will tell us how are they doing this like in the future. Because it's not just like 6, 10 meter wall. Like, it's a really huge wall. How they can see? I'm really curious. Like, look, it's just dark.
You can't fight. You can't see. You're afraid of heights and almost everything else, probably. What are you doing here, Sam?
On the morning of my 18th name day, my father came to me. You're almost a man now, he said. But you're not worthy of my land and title.
Damn.
Tomorrow, you're going to take the black.
Just imagine to...
If you do not, he said, then we'll have a hunt. And somewhere in these woods, your horse will stumble. And you'll be thrown from your saddle to die.
Just imagine to hear that from your father. Like... Damn. Sad? Really sad story?
Also, I'll tell your mother. Nothing would please me more.
Damn.
Do you see that boy? There. One of Varys' little birds. Now look, there. That one belongs to the Queen. And do you see that scepter? Pretending to read her book. Larissa the Queen. No, she's one of mine.
Damn. Castle is full of spies. And everyone like spies for different people. Are there like any normal workers or everyone is a spy?
Someone in your service whom you trust completely.
But Baelish, perhaps I was wrong to distrust you.
Distrusting me was the wisest thing you've done since you climbed off your horse.
The former hand did call on me, my lord, several times. Regret to say, he did not honor me with his patronage.
What did Lord Arryn want?
Always came to see the boy.
The boy?
Strong for his age. He works hard.
When Lord Arryn came to visit you, what would you talk about?
Just asked me questions is all, my lord. Then he started asking me about my mother.
Your mother?
Who she was, what she looked like.
What did you tell him?
She had yellow hair.
Yellow hair?
Sometimes.
Look at me.
Ooh. No.
Find anything?
King Robert's bastard son.
Yes. Yes, I was not wrong. Damn. That why was he asking?
This is for the king. The Lord's Dark.
How many do you think are in there with him? Guess.
Three.
At least two, yeah.
Four.
Come here. Okay. It seems more than four.
Can I leave this with you? The message from Lord Stark.
I don't serve Lord Stark.
So, like, the messenger from the hand of the king can't even speak with the king. Okay.
Where have you been?
Watch duty.
With Sam.
Ah, Prince Porkchop. Where is he?
He wasn't hungry.
Impossible.
Impossible.
That's enough. You girls can do as you please. But if Thorn puts me up against Lady Piggy, I'm gonna slice me off a side of bacon.
Whoa. Oh, John's wolf.
No one touches Sam.
Okay.
Hit me. Go on, hit me.
These actors.
You think this is funny, do you?
Well, the commander is kinda right, but like, train him. Don't just beat him. Like, train him so he could do something.
You send this whore to give me commands. I should have sent you back her head.
Why did you hit her?
How many times do I have to tell you? You do not command
I
me.
I wasn't.
What's this?
It's a gift. I had it made for you.
Doth bracky rags, here.
You've no right to a braid. You've won no victories yet.
You do not talk back to me. You are a horse. And now you've woken the dragon.
I am the wife of the great Carl, and I carry his son inside me. The next time you raise a hand to me will be the last time you have hands.
Damn. Yeah, tell him.
But I like girls just as much as you do. They might not like me as much. I've never been with one. As a matter of fact, the same as you. Why exactly did you not make love to Roz with the perfect...
Yeah, why?
What's my name? John Snow? Why's my surname Snow?
Because you're a bastard.
I could think was... What if I got her pregnant? She had a child. Another bastard named Snow.
I see.
You boys even remember the last winter? How long's it been now? What, 10 years? Were the days when you just couldn't get warm, never mind how many fires your servants built. I spent 6 months out there, beyond the wall, during the last winter.
Ooh.
Supposed to be a 2-week mission. Soon we'll have new recruits.
Like, just to think about it.
Passed along to the Lord Commander for assignment.
Your brother Rhaegar was the last dragon. Viserys is less than the shadow of a snake.
He is still the true king.
Your brother? Wait, what? Your brother Rhaegar? So she had another brother. Oh, okay.
To see your brother sitting on the Iron Throne.
No, the common people are waiting for him. Illyrio said they are sewing dragon banners and praying for his return.
Are they?
My brother will never take back the Seven Kingdoms. He couldn't lead an army even if my husband gave him one.
Well, true.
He'll never take us home.
Yeah, especially if you think about it. The Robert, current king. His rebellion, it was successful. So, and he does not underestimate Viserys and Daenerys and Dothraki. He is not underestimating them. So it seems maybe he's not such a good king, but as a strategist, as a warrior, it seems he's really skillful. So against him. And like, they have Ned also, like a lot of good tacticians, so even with the Dothraki army it's impossible. Okay, tournament.
Why do they call you Littlefinger?
Arya.
When I was a child, I was very small, and I come from a little spit of land called the Fingers, so you see.
I see. Okay, now I understand why he's the little finger. So there is some story about it.
Sir Gregor Clegane, they call him
Gregor, the Mountain.
Hound's older brother,
Oh, I think Hugh will lose this fight, this duel. Just look at his guy, he's really a mountain, so huge. Damn.
Ooh.
Ouch.
Not what you were expecting. Has anyone ever told you the story of the mountain and the hound? Lovely little tale of brotherly love. One evening, Gregor found his little brother playing with a toy by the fire. Gregor's toy. He just grabbed his brother by the scruff of his neck and shoved his face into the burning coals.
Damn.
And there, while the boy screamed, while his face melted.
Savage.
You won't tell anyone, I promise.
No, please don't.
So why did you tell her that?
Your Grace.
You're missing your tournament.
Putting my name on it doesn't make it mine.
I thought we might put what happened on the King's Road behind us. Ugliness with the wolves. And forcing you to kill the beast was extreme. Though sometimes we go to extremes where our children are concerned.
What are you doing here?
I might ask the same of you. What is it you hope to accomplish?
The king called on me to serve him and the realm. And that's what I'll do until he tells me otherwise. I was also trained to kill my enemies, Your Grace.
Hmm.
As was I.
And to you.
Boy, bread, meat and beer, quickly.
Oh, good idea, Grandfather, I'm starving.
I'm sorry, my lord. We'll fill up every room.
Ooh.
Then you can sleep in the stable. As for myself, I don't require a large room.
You can have my room.
Now, there's a clever man. Lady Stark. What an unexpected
pleasure. Damn.
I was sorry to miss you at Winterfell.
I was still Catelyn Tully the last time I stayed here.
She was hiding.
Is that the black bat of Harrenhal I see embroidered on your coat?
It is, milady.
The red stallion was always a welcome sight.
I like how in previous episodes she also did not expect that someone will recognize her, but just immediately. And now also she's trying to hide, but Tyrion.
My father counts Jonas Bracken amongst his oldest and most loyal bannermen.
Our lord is honored by his trust.
I know your sigil as well. The Twin Towers of Frey. How fares your lord, sir?
Lord Waldo is well.
Okay, we're learning a lot of.
Your father for the honor of his presence on his 90th name day.
We learned a lot of names of the families in the north. So, but I'm not remembering them yet. I hope we will interact more with these families. I hope it's not just in this scene that they mentioned it and that's all. So I hope these names are important.
This man came into my house as a guest and there conspired to murder my son, a boy of 10. In the name of King Robert and the good lords you serve, I call upon you to seize him.
Ooh.
To await the king's justice.
Do you? Whoa, that was the whole episode. Damn. That went fast. But okay. Okay, so that was episode 4 and it was more peaceful episode than the previous ones, but still good, yeah, still interesting, a lot of new info. But yeah, well, Tyrion came to Winterfell from the wall. He gifted Bran some kind of device so Bran can ride a horse. Okay, a nice gift, really nice for the cripple. And like he said, he likes cripples, bastards and broken things. Like this episode is called, so it was quite funny. And also we saw how Jon is training with other knights of the watch, and we were introduced to a new character, Sam, this big guy who can't fight, who is a coward, like he said himself. But it seems he's quite a sweet character, really kind. So yeah, he and John became friends. So yeah, really good character. I liked him, and he had a really sad story that his father sent him here because his father does not care about him. So he said, go to the wall, or like basically I will kill you. So to hear this from your parent. Also, Ned, he started investigating Lord Aaron's death, previous Hand's death. So he asked Grandmaster. It seems that he often visited the Grandmaster in his last days. So Ned was really interested what he wanted. This Grandmaster, he showed Ned the book that Lord Aaron asked previously. This book about houses and history of Seven Kingdoms. Arya is training and I like how Ned told Arya that you will marry a High Lord, you will be his castle's like a ruler, basically. Yeah, you will have a lot of kids, princesses. Yeah, but Arya said, no, it's not me. She likes fighting. She is a fighter. She wants to become a warrior, not like her sister Sansa. She wants to be a princess, okay? She is happy to be a princess, to wear beautiful dress, to eat glorious food, to visit tournaments, and etc. So yeah, you see my point. Also, Littlefinger, he told Ned about a lot of spies are inside the castle, and like they are everywhere, basically. Like there are spies for Lord Varys, for Queen, for Littlefinger himself. So yeah, it was really funny. Like there are no normal workers there, everyone is a spy. Such a funny moment. Also, Ned learned from Littlefinger that Lord Arryn, the previous hand, he often visited the smithy, the boy in smithy. And Ned also went to this place and he found a boy, asked about what Lord Arryn wanted, and Lord Arryn was asking about this boy's mother. And yeah, Ned figured out that this boy is King Robert's bastard. They also saw that Viserys is not happy when Daenerys calls him, because he sees it like that she commands him, but it's not that. She just called him to dinner to give him gifts, but he's not liking it. He's too prideful. Like he's so weak, so prideful. He's a coward. He's only brave in front of his sister, and with others he's really quiet and cowardly. So okay, not only in front of sister but also in front of slaves. So yeah. And Daenerys thinks that her brother, even with Dothraki's help, he won't be able to conquer Seven Kingdoms. Like he's not a good warrior, not a good tactician. So especially if you compare him to King Robert, who is a good warrior in the past, a good strategist, tactician. And especially Robert's rebellion, it was successful, so he is good. I don't know what Viserys is thinking. And yeah, we saw the tournament, and we learned a bit of about Hound and his elder brother Mountain. Okay, Mountain is easier to remember, so I will call him Mountain and Hound. And the last scene, we saw that Lady Catelyn and Tyrion, they met in the tavern. Like she was still hiding, but like in previous episode, she was immediately recognized, this time by Tyrion, and she arrested him. I don't think this was a good idea, because I think Ned was planning something to do with Lannisters, and now she kinda intervened with his plan, I think. Maybe I'm overthinking it, but still, they don't have a really good evidence. Like, the knife, this dagger, like, what? He easily can say that he lost it. Like, the little finger, he can say the same, so... there's definitely a third party that playing this game. Really, Game of Thrones, so... Yeah. That was the whole episode, basically, and yeah, we learned names of the houses that live in the north. Like, Frey... like, there were, like, 5 or 6 names. I only remember Frey. But I hope they will also mention it in the future. I hope it's not for this only scene. So, I will learn. Yeah. This was a whole episode, basically. Pretty chill, pretty calm episode. But, yeah. Anyways, let me know in the comments what do you think about this episode or Game of Thrones overall. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and leave a comment down below. All important links will be in the description of this video. See you next time.